Alright, so now we are going to solve the problem 17-6 from the exercise from your handbook. So you should have the statement of this problem in front of you. It is the same statement for problem 17-5 and 17-6 with a little difference. So the statement says that how many surfaces are needed in a wet disc clutch. So it is a wet disc clutch. So wet disc clutch is actually a type of friction clutch, and it is being called wet because there has been lubrication there in the clutch. So how many surfaces are needed to transmit 120 Newton meter of torque? So we are given with the torque which needs to be transmitted, and that is 120 Newton meter at a speed of 1000 RPM. So further it tells the type of lining. So the friction lining is sintered lining, and then it says it has a maximum pressure of 1.8 megapascal. So this lining has a maximum pressure of 1.8 × 10⁶ pascals, right? The coefficient of friction is also given, which is mu is equal to 0.06. Now in problem 17-6, it says that you should assume the condition of uniform pressure distribution. So we have studied two conditions. One is uniform pressure and the other one is uniform wear. So in this problem we are given that we should assume uniform pressure condition here. Then so actually what we need is the quantity n, right, which is the number of disc pairs. So this is required. And further, we are also required to find out the outside and inside diameters. So D outer and D inner are also required, while we are given the condition that the inner radius is 0.577 times the outer radius. So this condition we already have studied in the theory. And lastly, we also need to find out the power transmitted. So if this much torque is being transmitted at this speed, so the power transmission calculation is fairly simple. But our main objective here is actually to find out this n and then these diameters or radius, inner and outer radius or diameters. So let us start. So first of all, since we are given with the condition of uniform pressure, we should write down its formulas, which we have already derived for our reference. So in case of uniform pressure condition, we know that the formula that are applicable is the actuation force, the force that you apply in order to engage the clutch plates, that is F is equal to pi P into R outer square minus R inner square. Then the torque, so we are given with torque transmitted, it depends upon, so it has the formula of 2 pi 3 pi, or actually we should write N pi Sorry, so we should actually write the final form of this formula. So the final form of this part formula was n mu f, and then we had multiplication by 2 by 3, and then it was r outer cube minus r inner cube divided by r outer square minus r inner square. So these were the formulas that we have already derived in the theory. So what we have been asked to find out mainly is actually n, right? Because we are given with t. But the problem here is that we are not given with any of the radii. So we don't know the inner radius, we don't know the outer radius, but we know the relationship between these two. So in order to find out any of these quantities, we need both of these values. So what we are going to do is, we are going to make an assumption, right? So if I start the solution here, so we are going to make an assumption on one of the radius values. And once we have that, we can actually move on to find out the other radius value. So let's assume that r inner is equal to, now this value can be anything depending upon the application and the experience. So I am going to take here a round value of 30 millimeter. So if r inner is 30 millimeter, this means that we can find out r outer, which will be 30 divided by 0.577, and this value is going to be about 52 millimeter. So now that we know r inner and r outer, we just have to multiply it by 2, right? And we will find out d outer and d inner. So that part is done, and more importantly, we now have these two values. And these two values can be used to find out the actuation force. So putting these values here in the actuation force formula, we have F is equal to pi, then there is P. So the P is given in the data. This is 1.8 megapascal. So 1.8 into 10 to the power 6. Right, and then we have this r naught or r inner, so we have 0.052 in meters, right, squares, minus 0.030 square, and when we solve this, we get the axial force, which is 10,201 newtons, or about 10.2 kilonewtons. Now we needed this F because we want to find out the number of surfaces needed. And for that we need F. We are already given with torque. Now if I use this formula for torque, so I can put 120 in terms of torque, and then I'll have N, which is unknown, right? And then I have mu. Mu is given as 0.06, right? This F we just found out, 10,201. Then we have this factor of 2 by 3. And then we have these outer and inner radius. So above we have cube, and on down we have square, 0.030 square. So from here we can actually find out the value of n, and this value of n, when we solve this, it comes out to be 5. So this is our final answer. If this value is not an integer. It is not a whole number. We can round up it to the whole number. For example, if this answer is 4.8 or 4.5 or something, we will make it a 5, because the number of surfaces cannot be in the fraction. It has to be a whole number. So this is our final answer, n is equal to 5, which was asked in the beginning. And finally, we are also required to find out the power, right? So for power, actually, we don't need any of this. We only need is power is equal to T into omega. So T is 120 Newton meter, it is given. Omega or angular velocity can be found out by the RPMs given. So this is going to be 2 pi 1000 divided by 60. So the answer comes out to be 12566 watt. So this is the answer for the power transmitted. So fine, so this is all for this problem. So now that you have solved the example 17-1, one of the problems from the exercise 17-1 or 2 I solved, and now this problem. So now you should be able to solve other problems. And these problems that I have already assigned, these are the problems 17-1 until 17-6 and example 17-1. So please do it before the next lecture, and you have to submit these online on the Teams. Thank you.